Saltmine Studios in Mesa, Arizona. Super chill, like it's almost like a Mexican beach house type deal. It's super cool vibes.
You ready? We're doing this.
Fast forward. Go fast.
Fast motion. Go. Nobody loves me.
Nobody cares. This is the entrance to where we're doing drums and this and that.
And check out this drum room. It's me. It's like I'm not.
Chad and Greg from Mudvayne and HELLYEAH. They produced the album, did some writing with us, and they were fucking phenomenal. They're very talented gentlemen that we look up to dearly. Been listening to them for years and years and years. Great guys. Learned so much from them, mostly about drinking and a little bit about music too. We went in there, recorded 13 songs, we picked 12 for the album. Nobody wants me. It's like I'm not
even fucking there. No. The recording was just friends of ours in tiny little studios, usually bedrooms. This was really cool going to an actual facility. And then having Chad and Greg producing it, which was incredible. You know, having people that we looked up to be there with us, writing, throwing in ideas.
It's time to check out this control room.
Yeah. All right, this is where we're doing all our shit, recording drums and whatnot.
Yeah.
This is our engineer David, and one of our producers, Greg.
What up?
Yeah. From hell, I'm everything you're
not. I wear it up so well. Dude, recording.
A lot of Coors Light.
Yeah.
Yep.
Coors Light. Yep.
Yep.
And a lot of chicken wings. I mean, it's kind of like our first real album that the world's gonna hear, so you don't really know what to think when you're going into it, and you just kind of take it step by step, and it worked out fantastic.
Yeah.
We like the party.
We like the party.
Hey, keep it down, Play. There's no fly zone.
Jeremy Parker, who's an Arizona native, came down and mixed the record. He's worked a lot with Chad and Greg. Worked on a couple of Mudvayne records. He's worked on Godsmack, Evanescence, a bunch of really big rock and metal albums. And he came down and mixed it and did a great job. And he's a kick-ass dude.
We had, like I said, 40 songs, and we had a whole bunch of really heavy songs. We had a whole bunch of kind of softer songs, and so we didn't really know which direction to go. Once we finally all had to kind of figure out what style we wanted to go with, which Chad and Greg also helped with. I think it just, kind of just went with the just ballsy rock stuff, kind of in between heavy and soft. And I mean, there's still some ballady stuff in there, but I think we're just going with the balls fucking rock.
Nice.
Balls fucking rock.
Yeah. So for fans of balls fucking rock.
Just make me look cool, man.
Not much in here anymore. This drawer used to be completely full. Like this drawer. And you better believe we have someone coming to bring some more just to refill it up.
Yeah. Show me what it's
the essential. Beer and music.
Trust me, it's gonna be beer in it. It's gonna look cool. You're not gonna see it, but it's gonna look cool.
What's happening?
Nothing.
Sweet.
Good conversation.
I didn't know I was supposed to talk to you.
Yeah, no. Yeah, interview me.
So, what's been happening down here?
See you later.